In today's orchestration hack, I'll be showing you two ways to apply some tempo rubato to your compositions, meaning to add some slight tempo changes to enhance the flow of your music. The first one is quick and easy, and the second one takes a little bit more time, but I think it's worth it in the end. Let me first explain you what tempo rubato means. Tempo rubato, which is Italian for stolen time, is a playing technique where the performer or the conductor of an orchestra slightly changes the tempo according to what he or she thinks the music needs. They follow the phrasing of the music and speed up or slow down wherever they think it would fit the flow of the music. It is originally an instruction by a composer written down in the score, but it's so inherent to performance that I would prefer to think of it as a performing technique rather than a compositional instruction. Especially in slower pieces, tempo rubato can really enhance the emotional impact of a piece and make the music come alive. The music you're hearing right now is a very clear example of tempo rubato. It is a very famous nocturne by Chopin. If you listen carefully, you can really hear how the performer, Arthur Rubinstein in this example, really takes the time to make the melody a little bit slower where he thinks it's needed, or when he has a group of shorter notes to make sure that he's really playing towards the resolution of it. Crescendos are often accompanied by a slight speeding up of the tempo, and all of these changes are what Rubinstein thinks are fit for this music and the phrasing of the music, and he changes the tempo accordingly. And doing this well is what separates the great performers and the great conductors. They really know how to nail the timing of a next chord or the ending of one, or how to just slightly speed up when they approach a climax, only to slow down then when they have reached it. And since there are as many opinions on what is good phrasing as there are performers and even listeners to classical music, in the end this is very personal. You as a performer has to decide for yourself what feels right when playing this piece. And since as composers of virtual orchestrations we are basically our own performers as well, we have to be aware of this. And when working in a DAW, you're very often working with a very rigid click track to keep track of everything that you're doing and to keep everything coherent. However, with the next two tips I want to show you how you can achieve a sense of tempo rubato within your virtual compositions. The first and a little bit quicker way to achieve this effect is by using the tempo track, which can be altered by inserting either quick jumps or more gradual changes. In this piece, which is for the new album I'm writing, I use this to create some breaks in between the phrases of my lyrical opening section. And I'll first play you the example without the breaks. So when listening to this, I feel a certain kind of unease when we hit the breaks here at bar 14 and 16. I wanted to add a little bit more breath in there, and to create those, I used the tempo track. Here I have my tempo track. So here I have one of those breaks at bar 14, and what I do is just click, click, and make a dip. So this way, when we reach this point, the tempo becomes very slow, so we have a little bit of a break, and then it picks it back up again. And when determining how long this should be, I try to make things very, you know, personal or physical. I try to imagine if I were the conductor standing in front of my own virtual orchestra, and when I would have this break, when would it feel right for me to continue? So I'm making like posh gestures like that when I'm trying to apply this. But doing this really helps me to understand what the flow of the music is and where it feels right to continue. And when the tempo changes I've applied align with this, then I have the feeling I have succeeded and I can move to the next one. So after doodling around a bit, I finally came up with these three short breaks, and let me just play you how it sounds. I think this has way more breath and a more natural flow than the first time I played it. The other example involves actual performing something yourself. In this piece, I have a lyrical opening section with an elaborate melody in the string section. And to achieve this sense of tempo rubato here, I chose to record myself playing the piano first. And to do this, I gave myself 4 clicks of an introduction, then I removed the click and start playing. So this way I knew the tempo, but I wasn't held back by this click track trying to stress me out when I was trying to really perform the music. Towards the climax, when I added the click track, you can hear I drifted quite a bit off tempo, and in the end we were about 3 beats off the regular one of the click track. So when I'm programming the orchestra around it, I either listen to the piano cue or I line the MIDI parts up so I know when the timing is. So here in this example I have the bass line added and I know exactly where it is and I can time it accordingly. When the orchestration is done, I can remove the piano, but in this instance I kept a little bit of it because I thought it was a nice sound added to the climax. And because my final note is of an undetermined length, I can put back these little transitional notes on the grid, so I am back on the grid when I'm going into the next section. And while I did this with piano, you can do this if you're more comfortable on a wind instrument or guitar or anything. What you could also do is record yourself playing and then use the recording as a reference and remove it in the end. I hope that was helpful. Good luck adding some natural tempo changes in your own music, and I would love to hear them. If you have any tips or other thoughts regarding this subject, don't hesitate to leave them in the comments below. Like if you did, and subscribe if you haven't. And as always, from my space to yours, I hope you have a great day.